I'm ruined. Half of New England saw me today as a rutting pig.
Come on, Frazier. You're not in rut. You're in love.
Oh, nonsense. I don't think that because two people breathe heavily on a TV show is any cause for them to declare their undying love.
Breathe heavily? I thought you were going to suck in a chair there. Listen, TV station may not have been the best place in the world to sprout antlers, but it happened. Go with it.
Dr. Stern, and you're back. Diane, I'd like to thank you for your Pygmalion-like efforts. I'd like to, but I can't because they led to disaster. Good evening, Dr. Crane.
Dr. Stern, it's nice to see you again.
And you? I apologize for my overzealous behavior this afternoon and for making fools of us both.
Yes, well, I would also like to apologize for my completely unprofessional attitude and promise you that that sort of thing will never happen again.
Fine. I've already penned a letter to the American Psychiatric Association apologizing for my behavior. I would suggest that you do likewise.
Of course, of course.
And I think perhaps for the sake of our professional reputations, it's best we put this matter behind us and go on with our lives.
Oh, that is probably wise. You see, I've already lost 3 patients as a result of today's fiasco.
That's odd. I picked up 3. While we're on the subject, Dr. Crane, I suggest that your behavior indicates an unacceptable level of sexual frustration. You strike me as a man who needs professional help, or perhaps a girlfriend.
And you strike me as a woman who could use a good cuffing.
Good day, Dr. Crane.
Good day, Dr. Sternin.
Just a moment, Dr. Sternin. Sam, isn't the refrigerator door stuck again?
I don't think so.
Oh, I think it is. And we need a hairpin to open it up. Dr. Sternin, could we borrow a hairpin?
I don't see how a hairpin will help.
Strangely enough, it does.
Oh, but don't you see? What these two people, who are such geniuses at romance, are trying to do is to get you to take your hair down, thinking that it will stimulate me like some sort of Pavlovian dog. So why don't you just oblige them, get this silliness over with so we can get on with our lives.
You mean like this?
Precisely. You know what?
What?
I'm going to kiss you. I'm going to kiss you hard, and I'm going to kiss you long. But make no mistake about it, I am going to kiss you. In fact, I'm going to kiss you like you've never... Yes, like that. Now listen, Lilith, I think you and I have just been too articulate for words. We talk and we talk, and what we really want to do is show how we feel.
I think, Dr. Crane...
Look, I don't care what you think. We both want to be animals. Now I'm going back to my tastefully decorated townhouse and prove it. Well, I suggest you come with me.
I think I see what you're trying to do, Dr. Crane, and I just want you to know... it worked.